Hello class everyone, this is your chemistry class and today's class we are going to discuss about organic nomenclature. So let's start the class. So today's class we are going to start from how to draw organic compound structure from the given IUPAC nomenclature. So the first example includes, first one is diethyl butane 1,4-dioene. It is given as, IUPAC name is given as diethyl butane 1,4-dioene. Butane 1,4-dioene. Okay. So first you find what will be the number of carbon atoms. See, it is but, so number of carbon atom is 4 here. Put number of carbon atoms like this, 4 carbon atoms, C. Okay. Next is dioene. By seeing this suffix oene, you can easily understand that it is going to be ester. And which ester? This is ethyl ester. See, this diethyl, ethyl ester. So C double bond O, OCH2CH3. And here also C double bond O, OCH2CH3. Now see, ethyl, this one is another ethyl. So diethyl, put the numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4 means but. So diethyl butanoate. So diethyl butane, this is butane, 1,4-dioene. Now put the number of hydrogen atoms accordingly depending upon the valency of carbon. So here it will be CH2, here it will be CH2. So this is the dash line formula, that is the diethyl butane 1,4-dioene. So in condensed form it should be written as C double O CH2CH3 CH2 CH2 C double O CH2CH3. This is the condensed form of this dash line form. Okay. CH3CH2 C double O CH2CH2 C double O CH2CH3. Next example is number 2. Pentan 2-ohm. So again here the suffix is ohm and you can get this as ketone. Okay, the suffix ohm represents the ketone, so it is ketone. First thing you are getting, and the second thing, number of carbon atoms should be pent. It is pent, so number of carbon atoms is 5 here. So put 5 carbon atoms, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 2-ohm. That means carbon number 2 bearing the double bond of ketone group. Ketone group is present at carbon number 2. So 2 ohm. So put ketone group at carbon number 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Next is 5 chloro. At this carbon number 5, there is one chlorine group. So this is chlorine. Okay. Carbon number, this would be 3. 5 chloro, 3 ethyl. Pentan 2-ohm. Now, okay, 5 chloro, 3 ethyl, pentan 2-ohm. So, this carbon number 3 is bearing the ethyl group. So, it is going to be CH2CH3. Now, put hydrogens by fulfilling valency of carbon, CH2CH2Cl. And here is CH3. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pentan, 2-ohm, 5 chloro, 3, this one will be CH, 1, 2, 3 and 4, CH, okay. So 5 chloro, 3 ethyl, pentan, 2-ohm, 5 chloro, 3 ethyl, pentan, 2-ohm. Next is 2-methyl butanoyl chloride. Two methyl butanoyl chloride, number 3. 2-methyl butanoyl chloride. Butanoyl chloride. Anoyl chloride means COCl group present. By seeing the suffix, by observing the suffix, you can get which functional group is present. So anoyl chloride means COCl group. But means carbon number 4. Carbon number 4, including this carbon. For this anoyl chloride, this COCl group, butan means butan, carbon number 4, and number 4 includes this carbon atom. So C, 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 and this carbon atom is for this C double bond to Cl. As this is functional group, we can get that numbering should be done from the functional group side. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 2-methyl, put methyl group here. 2-methyl butanoyl chloride and put number of hydrogens accordingly. CH3, CH2, CH3, C double bond to Cl. So this is 2-methyl butanoyl chloride. Okay. So first thing is, what is the functional group present? Anoyl chloride, so COCl. What should be the number of carbon atoms? Total number of carbon atoms is 4, as it is but, including this carbon, so 1, 2, 3, 4, and put the substituent accordingly, and number of hydrogens depending upon valency of carbon. Next example, 3-methyl-2-enoic acid. Example number 4, 3-methyl-2-enoic acid. So number of carbon, probe. So 3 carbon atom, put 3 carbon atom, 3-methyl, if I give the numbering as 1, 2, 3. So 3-methyl means here methyl is a substituent here. 2-enoic, number carbon atom 2 is bearing the double bond. So 2-enoic acid, anoic acid to enoic acid. When no double bond is present, that is anoic acid and that is acid group. And enoic acid means due to the presence of double bond. So C double O H group. And I repeat that numbering should be done from that from the carbon atom of the functional group. If functional group bears any carbon atom, then numbering should be done from there. So 1, 2, 3. You see, now put the number of hydrogens. Here lacking 1. Here also lacking 1. This. So this is 3-methyl probe. 2-enoic acid, 2-en, see this is probe 2-en, so probe 2-enoic acid. Okay, 3-methyl probe 2-enoic acid. Okay, so today's class we have discussed 4 compounds examples, that is how to draw the organic compound structure from given IUPAC nomenclature. Next class we will discuss some more examples where both more than one functional groups are present. Okay, so both example we will discuss, that is how to draw structure and how to do organic nomenclature where both more than one functional groups are present.